We're supposed to be there at 8-ish. We should come on, we should get going.
You just get in the way. Oh, you're not wearing that tie with that shirt, are you?
Well, I love this tie.
You can't wear a blue shirt with a green tie. You know, blue and green should never be seen.
Well, that's stupid. What, just because green and seen rhymes? I mean, what about orange and vermilion? You look a million, that rhymes, but it's not true, I think.
Oh, look, why don't you just be a bit more casual? It's only Neil and Moira's.
Was this Australian Chardonnay the one we enjoyed so much last week?
Yeah, I think so.
Wait a minute. What about this Bulgarian, then?
Oh, don't take that. It's cheap plonk.
No, that's perfect. We'll take it.
Oh, should we have some cheese puffs or something before we go?
No way. I want to be absolutely starving for this meal. We've had Moira and Neil over for dinner so many times. This is the first time they've invited us back.
Oh, you're just being petty.
I'm not being petty.
Yes, you are. You're always comparing. Just relax.
I am relaxed.
Oh.
It's just that they owe us a really nice meal, that's all. In fact, Neville and Isabel had dinner at their place the other week, and they said they made them this wonderful Indian banquet from a Madhu Jaffrey recipe book. Apparently, they did a whole tandoori oven thing with naan breads, homemade lime pickle, papadoms, everything.
Ooh, that sounds really nice.
Yeah, so don't worry, just save your appetite.
It's 8:10. I told Bob and Margaret to be here at 8.
Don't worry. By the time they finish their dinner and get here, it'll be about 8:20, 8:25.
Well, I did say 8-ish, so they might arrive at 8.
I hardly think they'll arrive at 8 o'clock exactly. You don't do that. When a person says 8-ish, it means... Well, it means a little bit after that.
Yeah, but half an hour.
Well, 25 minutes tops. It's unusual to arrive exactly on time, and I think a little inconsiderate. Are you eating that piece of garlic bread?
No. Go ahead.
I can't remember what their house looks like. Isn't it a small Edwardian?
What, with those big curvy windows?
No. That's practically Georgian. I mean when the Victorian just started to give way to Edwardian. You know, casement windows instead of the double-hung sashes. Anyway, it's number 83.
Oh, look! There's a space on the left! Daisy.
Oh dear, it's only 8:10.
Are we supposed to be there at 8?
Well, yes, but we don't want to be there right on time.
8:10 isn't right on time.
Well, it's practically right on time. They'll think we haven't got a life. Like we just woke up and sat around all day waiting to attend their precious dinner party.
So why did we leave so early?
I thought by the time we got here and parked and everything, it would be about 8:20 or 25. Yeah.
So 8:10 means we have no life, but 8:20 means we got off Concord from New York and we got stuck in traffic on the way from Heathrow.
Well, that's good. Yes, I like the sound of that.
Oh, that's really stupid.
Let's just wait here a few minutes more.
Oh, gosh. It'd be really nice to relax tonight. It's too bad we've got visitors coming.
Oh, I know. I'm really tired. Why did you invite them over?
Because we've been to their house a lot. I just wanted to stop feeling guilty.
We shouldn't have gone to their house so many times. We don't have anything in common.
I know, but they cook nice food.
Yes. They did a lovely roast beef last time.
Mmm. Yeah, it was nice and pink.
The Robin Hood roundabout is severely congested.
Maybe we should have made them dinner tonight.
Look, you told them to come for drinks. Don't worry.
Yeah, okay.
Hello.
Come in.
Just fine, thank you. Come in. Oh, is that a new sofa?
No.
Oh, well, something seems different, I'm sure.
I don't think so.
Can I get either of you a drink? Some wine?
Oh, we bought this one.
Oh, Bulgarian Liebfrau milk. That sounds nice.
Oh, it is, yes. We had a bottle of it last week and thought it was really, really nice with food.
Oh, and it's got this this handy screw top. I'll go and put it in the fridge. What would you both like to drink?
Oh, I'd love a glass of red wine, actually.
Oh, me too.
I'll open a bottle. With my corkscrew.
I'll help get the drinks together.
How could you say that about the wine?
Oh, what am I going to say? Hello, I bought the cheapest wine we had in the house.
Why can't we bring something nice instead of what's on special offer? It's so embarrassing.
Well, don't blame me. You agreed to it.
I didn't agree. You just brainwash me all the time.
I brainwash you? Oh, yeah. Since when did I gain this mind control power over you?
What wine are you opening?
This Chilean Cabernet that you like.
No, that's my favourite wine. Why are you giving it to them?
What do you mean? You'll drink it too.
Yeah, but look at the crappy wine they brought us.
Well, I'm sure they don't mean to be bringing the cheapest wine they can buy. They probably just had it in the house.
You think I'm being really nasty?
Oh, no, not nasty. Just don't make such a big thing about the wine.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry.
Oh, look at this photo. Why do people have pictures of themselves on display in their own house? It's a bit, I don't know, self-obsessed.
Well, it's a wedding photo.
I think it's a bit strange. Look at those shoulder pads.
Maybe we should have our wedding photo up in the house.
Ugh, that would be horrible.
It would be horrible.
I don't mean horrible. I just find the idea of a big photo of ourselves on the mantelpiece, well, I don't know, it just makes me feel a bit sick.
Thanks a lot.
Oh, the wedding was bad enough. All those people staring at us. Next time I get married, it'll be in a registry office.
What do you mean, next time?
Oh, I just mean if there was a next time. Don't start.
Ugh, Moira, these glasses are filthy. Why don't you go out there and make chit-chat and I'll try and salvage them.
Oh, no, I hate making chit-chat. Anyway, I've got lots to do in here.
We can't just leave them sitting out there.
OK, you go and I'll clean the glasses.
Don't be silly.
You see, you don't want to go out there any more than I do.
They seem to be taking a long time in there, don't they?
Well, they're probably taking care of the dinner.
What do you suppose they're cooking?
Don't know. I thought I smelled garlic earlier, but now I'm not too sure. I think I smell lemons.
I think that's a furniture polish.
Well, look, I'll poke my nose in the kitchen and see if I can find out what's going on.
Oh! Hello! We're just, cleaning up these glasses.
They were really filthy.
All right. I just wanted to use the loo. Is it upstairs?
Yes, just up on the first landing.
We just installed a power shower.
All right. That's nice. I don't think they're cooking anything in there.
What are they doing in there?
Well, I don't know. Washing the wine glasses. They aren't cooking.
Oh, this is stupid. They invited us for dinner. Gosh, my nose looks so big. They did invite us for dinner, didn't they?
Well, yes. I mean, I think so.
What do you mean you think so?
Well, Neil didn't actually say the words for dinner as such, but he invited us for 8, which is definitely dinner time-ish.
You mean they didn't actually mention food itself? But I thought you said something to them about bringing wine for dinner.
Yes, of course I did. I asked if we should bring red or white, and he said either would be fine. And I figured, I don't know, maybe they'd be cooking a vegetarian meal or something, so either would be fine.
Oh, I'm absolutely starving. Why didn't you let me eat those cheese puffs?
Oh, it's that mind control thing I have over you again, isn't it?
Oh, stop it.
You know, I even asked if we should bring a dessert or something. I mean, what do you have to do? Spell it out to people? Do you have to say, are you going to feed us?
Maybe it's some cold thing in the fridge. They'll probably come out with it any second.
Yeah, like a cold salad selection or maybe Scotch eggs.
Ooh, that sounds revolting.
Yeah, well, I'll take what I can get at this point.
I've got this Chilean Cabernet. It's very nice.
Oh, I thought it wasn't a good idea to drink Chilean wine.
Are you kidding? New World wines are really popular. This one was recommended in the Sunday Times.
No, I meant because of the Chilean regime. You know, I didn't think we were supposed to be buying things from Chile while their human rights record remains so poor.
Well, no, maybe not, but it's a bloody good wine.
Anyway, don't they have a democratically elected government now?
Oh, yeah, maybe they do. I suppose democracy's good, yeah.
Oh, I get so confusing. First we couldn't buy South African and now we're supposed to.
Is Colombian coffee okay?
I think so, but I'm not sure. You see, the Colombian coffee growers are oppressed by their government, so we should support them, but not the government. Or is that Honduras? Oh, I'm not sure. We should find out about that.
Well, maybe decaffeinated is okay.
Oh, peanuts! They look great.
Mmm, Sorry.
Yeah, that's very good.
They're dry roasted.
Yes.
Some wine will wash those down nicely.
Thank you. That would be nice.
Thank you.
Cheers.
That's nice.
Yes.
Chilean?
Yes.
I know. Why don't we play a board game?
What?
Oh, yeah. That what would you do game. It's brilliant. You get these cards with moral dilemmas on them and you have to guess what each player would do in a situation. Moira, is it in the guest room or in the bedroom cupboard?
Just a minute. I'll be right back.
A board game?
Oh, my stomach hurts from eating so many nuts.
Well, maybe this game will take our mind off food.
I hate board games.
You have these cards, you roll the dice, and depending on what you land on, you take a card from one of the subject boxes.
Yes.
You should just start to play. You'll catch on, it's really simple.
Yes, 10! Beat that!
What?
To see who goes first.
Oh.
5! Ha ha! We go first! Business dilemmas. These are usually interesting.
Okay, Bob. You are going away on a business trip to Thailand without your wife. While on this trip, a group of associates plan to go to a massage parlour. They invite you along. Do you accept the invitation?
What am I supposed to do? Do I just answer the question?
No. You don't say anything. We all decide what you would say, then you tell us. If we guess right, we win the round. If Margaret guesses right, then you win the round and you roll again.
You write it on this pad and keep it a secret.
Why are you taking so long? Of course you wouldn't go.
What do you mean? Massages are nice.
No, stop. You can't discuss it. That's not fair. Margaret has to guess what you would do.
Ooh, sorry. Okay, I've done. I've decided what I would do.
Good. We go first. What do you think, Moira?
Well, I don't know. Can you picture Bob in a massage parlour?
Oh, yeah. I mean, he's in Thailand. Why wouldn't he go to a massage parlour? That's like the main perk.
What are you talking about?
What?
What do you mean it's the main perk? Is that what you do when you're away?
No, of course not. I just mean that's what many businessmen would do. I think Bob would do it. I wouldn't.
Hey, I would do it, but you wouldn't. What's that supposed to mean?
No, I didn't. I just mean that I would not do that sort of thing, whereas you might be more adventurous, you know, more willing to try it out. I wouldn't have the guts to do that.
But you'd want to.
No. Oh God, I didn't mean that. I mean that if I wanted to, I wouldn't have the nerve to do it. Bob would. That's something I admire in him.
So we're saying that Bob would have the massage?
There's no question in my mind.
Well, there's no way Bob would do that kind of thing. Massage parlours are for depraved people with sexual problems.
Welcome to the human race.
Neil!
What did you say?
I said that I wouldn't go.
Good. I was right.
Oh, come off it. You would go.
No, I would not. It's not right to encourage that kind of exploitation of women.
Exploitation? These women are making a killing doing their job. They're not being exploited. No, sir, not at those prices. Okay, well, right, it's your role now, Bob, so we alternate boy-girl.
9. Let's see now. It says High Street Dilemmas. Okay, so here goes. You are in a supermarket checkout and an elderly woman pushes ahead of you in a rude way. As she is leaving, she drops a £5 note. You only notice it on the floor as she is exiting the shop. Do you chase after her and risk losing your place in the queue, or do you pocket the £5 and consider it a happy accident? That's for Moira, I suppose.
That's easy.
What do you mean, that's easy?
Oh, sorry, nothing. You write down your answer. Never mind. OK, you two go first this time.
Well, I don't know. It seems pretty obvious to me.
You don't keep a poor old lady's money.
No, a stupid question.
Is that your guess, then? Are you done?
Yes, definitely.
Well, I don't know what kind of goody-goodies you two are, but I know that Moira would keep the fiver.
That's awful. How can you say that?
How can I say that? The woman pushed in the queue. She doesn't deserve the £5. Moira would keep the money. I think most people would.
That's not true. You'd have to be pretty desperate to steal a poor old lady's money.
It's not stealing at all. The woman dropped it, and she's out the door. It's not hers anymore, and if you didn't pick it up, somebody else would. Give the money to charity if you need to expunge yourself of some imagined guilt. But it's your money if you find it.
I can't believe you're saying this. I've never heard such a cynical point of view. If I were Moira, I'd be just a little insulted, Neil.
Oh, come off. It's no different than picking up a newspaper that's been left by someone in a pub. You don't chase after the owner.
My good man, I'm afraid you've left your newspaper, which is rightfully yours.
That's completely different. You're talking about an old lady's money, not a used newspaper.
Well, let's find out what Moira said, shall we? Come on, Moira, what have you written down?
I said I'd keep the money.
Yes! I told you! My role, great. Lucky seven, gorgeous. Personal dilemmas, great. These are the best. This is for Margaret. All righty. Oh, this is good. Okay, Margaret, you have borrowed an electric can opener from a neighbour who you do not particularly like. Sometime later, the neighbour mentions that she cannot remember what she did with the can opener. Do you tell him, her, that you have the can opener, or do you seize the opportunity to keep a useful kitchen appliance for yourself? Right. Okay, Moira. What do you think?
Well, I'm not so sure. I suppose she might tell the neighbour. It's the decent thing to do, isn't it?
Oh, yes, but let's be honest. I mean, that's the point of the game. I would tell the neighbour, but I'm not so sure Margaret would. I think she would keep the can opener.
What do you mean? I would keep the can opener? What kind of thing is that to say?
I just think you would. It's the type of thing you would do.
He doesn't mean anything bad by it.
How can he not mean anything bad by it? It's insulting.
It's not insulting.
It is insulting. How could you say that about me?
Oh, come on. If you wanted the can opener, you'd keep it. Why don't you just be honest?
Honest? I am being honest. Maybe you would keep a neighbour's can opener. Maybe you would borrow something from a friend and then steal it. I wouldn't.
Margaret, it's not your turn. You're not supposed to give your opinion now.
You're right. Okay, let's get on with the game. Neil?
Okay. I'd say, well, we'd say, that you would, in fact, keep the can opener, right?
Yes, that's right.
Thank you. Bob?
Margaret would not keep the can opener. She would return it to the neighbour, as I would, because that is the decent thing to do. That is what Margaret and any decent person would do.
OK, Margaret, what did you write down?
I would not keep the fucking can opener.
Right. Well, then you win the round. It's your throw, Margaret.
Oh, good. Another domestic dilemma. This is for you, Neil. You and your lovely wife are guests for dinner at a friend's house. You are fed delicious, carefully prepared food and are invited back on a number of occasions. Eventually, you feel just a bit guilty and so you invite these friends back to your house. Do you give them a nice dinner akin to what you have received? Or do you give them a glass of wine and a little bowl of dry roasted peanuts?
What? What do you mean? Is this a joke?
Let me save you the trouble. I'll tell you what you would do. You would give them the nuts and the wine and you would make them play this stupid game because you are. And let's be honest, because otherwise, what's the point of the game? You are selfish, rude and incredibly dull people who I cannot stomach being with for another second. Party on the 12th? Why don't you two go bowling?
Well, thanks for the, bye.
Should we finish the game ourselves?
Mmm,
This is so good.
I can't believe I'm actually eating again.
You know, I think that old dear at the takeaway didn't charge us for the pork balls. Look here. They didn't charge us for the spring rolls either. I thought it seemed cheap.
Why don't you say something? It's such a nice family. I think they all live in a room above the shop.
Well, they should be more careful. They can't afford to make mistakes. I mean, if they can't even add up...
We should go back and give them the money.
Oh, you must be joking. You're right. Definitely are. I'll go right now. I'll go tomorrow. After work. Oh, look, Elizabeth and William have finished their barbecue pork. Where's their sweet and sour chicken?
It's right here.
Mmm.